inequality in many areas, and this is creating difficulties in the democracy. First of all, we are having illiteracy. In India, only 74.04%, that is according to the data of 2011, this only 74.04% people are educated. So there are a large number of illiterates in India. The widespread means affecting a large number of people. They are illiteracy is a serious threat to democracy. If in that illiteracy will be there, the people illiteracy means illiterate people means they are those who are unable to read and write. If illiteracy will be there, people will not be able to understand, read or write. What will happen? They will not be able to take good decision regarding government making, and this will affect the democracy a lot. Next is economic inequality. Widespread economic inequalities are found in India. Many inequalities are there on the basis of economy. 37%, that is Tendulkar committee report of the people, are living below the poverty line. Poverty line is there. It means that Tendulkar committee is a committee which reported that 37% of the people are living below that poverty line. And what is happening? The rich are getting richer and the poor are getting poorer. Next is social inequality. Though the Indian Constitution has made many provisions to establish social inequalities in India. Now, as we have studied earlier also, that many provisions are there which is providing many equalities. But beside that, they are discriminations are there, many differences are there, and it is same as in social inequality. Many discrimination are still done on the basis of caste, color, race, etc. is commonplace. Next is political inequality. It is considered necessary to enable citizens to develop themselves and participate in the affair of state. But what is happening here? Again, equality is there, people are not getting that proper chance, and democracy is again in a threat. Communalism. Communalism means a strong sense of loyalty to the interest of one particular group, especially any religious group, rather than to the society as a whole, which can lead to violence towards others. Now this communalism is spreading, and being a divisive feature, it pose means to create a serious threat to democracy. Now as it is increasing, it is creating many arguments between the people, and this is creating a very serious problem to the democracy. Last is lack of political stability. This political stability is essential if the democracy is to succeed fully in India. Means if we want the democracy will succeed fully in India, then political stability is needed. Stability means state or quality of being steady, means which will not change. But the last few years we have seen a lack of political stability both in the states as well as at the center. Means there is no political stability, that governments have been changing. During the year 1967 to 1997, three governments were formed at the center. This is stating that how political stability is not there in government. Means within 1 year, three governments were formed at the center. Means central government have been changed. Now with this topic, it is the end of the chapter, and I will share that PDF, in that you will get that answers of all objective questions and all very short and long answers also. And as I have explained earlier, that no need to write objective questions in your copy. Write only very short answer questions, short answer questions, long answer questions. And if it is having difference between or discuss kind of question, then you have to write a copy. Thank you.